Hello everyone! In this video you will see me make the fourth acrylic flower that I'm going to add to my fantasy series. Again, I'm using a smaller canvas as all the flowers in my fantasy series. And to create this acrylic flower, I'm going to use the dip technique again. So for the people that are new to my channel and like tutorials of different techniques in acrylic, resin and a lot more, consider to subscribe. Click the notification bell and select all, because that way you don't miss anything. So what I already mentioned, I'm going to create the fourth flower that I'm going to add to my fantasy series. And this one will get a black background. And I'm using the Liquitex Basics Mars Black for my base layer. And also the mix. I already made a video of how I mix my paints for these flowers. If you are curious and you want to see how I mix the paints and the pouring medium, then you can watch video 305. In that video I explain which supplies I'm using and also how I mix the pouring medium and the paints. And I'm using the pouring medium, the mix of Fiona Art. So she also has a video of how she mixes her paints. And I will add the link to her YouTube channel in the description box, so you can check it out. And I think she's the queen of these acrylic flowers. And she inspires me a lot. So please check out her channel. Maybe subscribe to it. I think she would appreciate that a lot. So working on the sides. And again, I'm going to use different colors. And when I was done with this flower, I thought, it looks a lot like Christmas colors. But I chose them on my feelings. I thought these colors would look great together. So the first color is the DecoArt Extreme Sheen 24 Karat Gold. And I'm going to use the dot technique. I don't know how it's called, but it's dripping colors on top of each other. The second color was from Arteza. It's the Pistachio. This color is the Phthalo Green by Winsor & Newton. This one is by Amsterdam, the Turquoise Green. And this is the Titanium White. And I'm using two pearl colors I have made from the Pistachio by Arteza, a pearl color, but also the Titanium White. And I'm also using the Neptol Red by Winsor & Newton. And again, I'm using the 24 Karat Gold, making dots around the center dot. And also this technique I saw on the YouTube channel of Fiona Art. So I wanted to try it out and see if I could make a beautiful flower with this technique. This was the Pearl Pistachio. Yeah, the mix of the paints, I can explain it short. I'm using an acrylic binder and a primer, and you need for the binder and the primer a synthetic resin dispersion. So if you Google on that word, then you will get all kind of supplies that have that in the binder. And I think together with the Phthalo Pearl medium, you can create that beautiful lacing effect. So those two supplies I mixed together in a ratio of 80% acrylic binder and 20% primer. That's the pouring medium. And to mix the paints, I use one part paint and four parts pouring medium for the pearl paints. I'm using one part paint, one part Vallejo pearl medium, and two parts pouring medium. And you can all see that in video 305, how I mix that, because I weigh everything. And again, I'm using a canvas of 20 by 20 centimeters. This one, not a round canvas, but a square. So, yeah, maybe that will also give a different look. Yeah, and it really looks like Christmas colors. But yeah, I like those colors together. And this takes some time to place all the dots on top of each other. Yeah, and I'm going to fill the whole canvas with these dots. That is the nice pearl color that I made from the Arteza Pistachio. Yeah, and when I choose my colors, I also choose transparent colors and semi-transparent colors, that I have a mix of those, and also opaque. You can see it on a bottle. There's a square on the bottle, and if it's totally filled, then you have an opaque color. If it's half full, then it's semi-transparent, and when it's empty, then it's a transparent color. So I make sure that I have a mix of those three together. And maybe that's also important to create the lacing effects. And what I also want to mention, Fiona Art at the moment is testing different pouring mediums. Because, yeah, if you can't buy the acrylic primer and binder outside of Europe, then, yeah, maybe you can also create the lacing effects with pouring mediums that you can buy where you live, like Liquitex pouring medium or Floetrol. She is testing that at the moment, and she makes videos of that, so maybe that's also interesting to watch. And all the supplies I'm using in this video, as I always do, you can find at the end of the video, but also in the description box with the links to the websites. So if you're curious, then you can check out where I buy my materials. And I also have some promo codes, some interesting promo codes in the description box. One of them is from Resin Pro. It's a resin company because I also do resin. And if you use my code Petra, then you get 10% discount on your total value order. So that's really nice of Resin Pro to do that. But I also am an affiliate of Jackson's Art Supplies. And if you are a new customer there and you buy through my links, then you get 10% discount on your first order. So that's also great, because you can also buy these supplies at Jackson's Art Supply. It's a UK based company, and they have really great art supplies. But yeah, all the information to that is in the description box. So I'm almost done with the Dutch, because my canvas is almost filled. Yeah, and the consistency you can also see in video 305, because it's very difficult to explain, because yeah, it's not thin but also not thick. Yeah, if you want to see that, then you can watch video 305, because I show also the consistency of the acrylic binder before I mix the paints, but also after I mix the paints, how thick it is then. And again, I'm going to use a paper napkin, just as Fiona does, because I have a smaller canvas, and then I can use a paper napkin. I don't have the larger one she has. So I make it a little bit wet with water, and I place it on top of the acrylic paint very carefully, and then I press the paper napkin into the paint. So not much pressure. I only make sure that the whole napkin is touching the acrylic paint. And then I take the corners and I lift them. I hold my hand in the middle and very carefully I'm going to lift the paper napkin. There you can see it. Yeah, and I'm liking it already. Those colors go very well together. Also at the end of this video, a close-up right after pouring, but also after 24 hours of drying. Then we can see if the painting changes or not. The torch for the air bubbles. Yeah, and it's a whole different look when you apply the acrylic paint in circles. But I'm also liking this. It's really nice. Tilting my canvas, because I want to see how much paint I have on my canvas. I must say, all the flowers I made dried very well, no cracks, and it dries very shiny, so that's good. Now a closer look right after pouring. And you can see the beautiful lacing. I hope you can see the sparkle. Because the pearl paint sparkle, but also the DecoArt 24 Karat Gold have some nice effects. Yeah, I'm liking it very much. Some different colored lacing. So this is a better close-up right after pouring. Then you can see the different colored lacing. I have it in red and in green. Really beautiful. So this is right after pouring, and I'm also going to show you a close-up after one day of drying. Then we can see if the lacing stayed or not. They are a little bit closer. There you can see the red lacing and the green. Yeah, I'm very pleased how it looks. Yeah, I have some comparable supplies in the description box, but I will search more on the comparable supplies to see if I can find something else. So this is after 24 hours of drying, and yeah, the lacing stayed, it didn't change, so yeah, I'm so pleased with this one. It sparkles a lot because of the 24 karat gold. Very nice. All the lacing still there. Now a closer look. Yeah, and if I find the supplies, I will for sure add it in the description box. There you can see the nice colors together, the greens and the red for the contrast. And the black background works very well with these colors. Maybe I will make one more with a black background. I'm not sure yet. Or another color. Yeah, I'm very pleased with this one. So if you are like what I'm doing, please subscribe to my channel. Give me a thumbs up for this video because that helps my channel a lot. All the information of the supplies I'm using in this video you can find at the end of the video, but also in the description box with the links to the websites. Also the link to my Facebook and Instagram you can find in the description box. And I'm also an Amazon influencers affiliate. So also the link to the Amazon store you can find in the description box. I want to thank you all for watching again, and I will see you in the next video. Bye!